was a TV ad. Rally for Jesus, all about life, in a mall. It said, "Who is Jesus?" I thought, do they really think we don't know? And Jesus needs a rally? My ears don't work. I'm almost deaf, so I don't do a lot of big group things. Sounds and words are so garbled, it's hard to get what's happening. So, well, I was at the mall for lunch, and I forgot the rally for Jesus right there by the food court. And there was singing and whatever, and a couple of people have talked, but I couldn't really get what they were saying. They seemed happy, though. And then a man came to the center of the courtyard, and he started to talk quite loudly, preaching about Jesus loving everything.
I saw the ads for it. The Jesus rally. Like everyone swaying, "Jesus loves me, this I know." Yeah, I know that song. I used to go to church sometimes. But seriously, Jesus loves me? How would you even know that if it were true? It's ridiculous, like fantastical. There's no way to know. So for now, I'm going without.
Well, it was on a football tour. I'm on an international travel team. Hey, I am a very good player. We play football every day in my neighborhood. And Mina, I was the best. You know, football is everything in my hometown. Although it is difficult to get to school all the time, and there is never enough money, but hey, there is always football. Our mothers complain every day about the dust ground into our clothes, but we have such a good time. And thanks to football, because now I'm on a big adventure.
And usually those loud, preachy guys don't interest me. All I can usually hear is the stuff they repeat, like, "Jesus! Jesus! Jesus!" It gets kind of irritating.
My family never did church, but I used to have sleepovers at my best friend's house, and we had to go to Sunday school. And I just remember pictures of Jesus everywhere, like a guy with a sheep or holding some children, and a lot of loud, long talking.
Our team competed in London and Amsterdam. Hey, I thought the supporters in Africa were loud, but that was before I played in Europe.
I watched them all rally. They seemed different.
I never fit in. I only had one good dress. Ugh, I hated that part of sleepovers. So eventually, I stopped going to her house so I didn't have to go to church.
On days between games, we visited attraction. We went out to eat. It's fun.
It's funny. They were all different cultures and types, but they seemed like they were having a good time together.
Jesus? Some kind of overly serious Bible teacher with a scraggly beard and dirty feet? It's funny, right?
There are no pictures of Jesus where I grew up. But I heard of Jesus, like a hero, Saladin or Marco Polo.
So the rally ended, and I'm still sitting there drinking my coffee, and then the guy, the Jesus guy, walks over to me with his lunch and asks if he could sit down. Sure, I say.
People want you to be a Christian because it's safer to imagine that everyone believes the same gods and loves the Lord. But I just don't.
Then, in Amsterdam, they took us into our Lord in an attic change. Hey, Lord, in the attic. Oh, God, in an attic change. Well, what's that?
I told him he'd have to talk loud so I could hear what he was saying, which made him laugh. Well, you know I could do that, he said. And we got talking about life and work and kids. He wanted to know about my hearing thing.
I have had so many people try to proselytize me, telling me that I'm I'm sick and I need God to heal me, or I'm blind and I need Jesus to help me see.
Our tour guide pointed out a very beautiful painting. It was a picture of Jesus. You know, it made me. I wanted to look at it the whole day.
It's a degenerative condition that eroded my hearing over time. Probably I'll eventually go totally deaf. Really? He said. Would you be interested in getting that healed?
Do I look sick or blind to you?
Then I asked my coach, do you know anything about Jesus?
Well, what do you say to that? Yeah, I'd like for my hearing to get fixed.
Every Sunday, I sit out on the front porch and I drink my coffee and I read my paper and I see all of these people, all dressed up, headed to the church across the street. And not one of them says hello. Does God need you to dress up? Does he care that I'm sitting there on the porch?
Well, I thought probably Coach would know. And he said yes, he did. On that, he will tell me everything about Jesus. Then we sat out on the porch and we talked.
So he said, could I pray for you with my team? And that felt kind of weird. I wondered, what are they going to do? But I'm still sitting there and I don't know. So I just said, yeah, sure.
Is there anything real here? Fancy clothes and a guy with a sheep? Long, loud sermons about sin and songs from 1803?
For certain, I wanted to know this Jesus. I thought this is the point of being here in Europe, so I can learn Jesus.
Man and a woman came over and Bill, the guy, the Jesus guy, explained that they were going to touch my shoulders while they prayed for me, if that was all right. All right, I said.
I'll be right over here with my coffee and my paper.
Now my life is a different path. I can talk to Jesus like a person.
They prayed, and at first I couldn't hear what they were saying, except occasionally I could make out a word, heal, or, well, Jesus. But I started feeling kind of warm, and then And then I almost wanted to cry. I don't know why.
Because after you get all dressed up, you still have to deal with all the bad vibes. Crusades, injustice, racism, abuse. It's not like the church comes off looking great.
Things are turning out so differently. Can you imagine? I'm working with the refugees back home when we are not on tour. I show them how to play football.
And after a few moments, I thought, this is weird. I can understand them. I had my eyes closed. Usually I read lips so I can understand things, but not now. I could hear.
Spiritual life? It's kind of interesting. Just not churchy life, I guess.
Well, besides football, I'm introducing Jesus to a lot of my friends. My coach gave me the book, and you should learn these great stories.
I could hear. I can hear. I can hear. The doctor tested me. He can't think of another case reversing this way. It makes me want to say, Jesus, real loud, just so I could hear myself.
I have this friend at work who invited me to this thing at her church. I don't really see it, but I told her I'd think about it.
I'm going to learn this stuff good so I can help my friends back home.
It's not a bad trip to the mall, right?
I don't want to hurt her feelings, you know.
They've got to learn Jesus.
I could hear Jesus! It's so cool.
But really, Jesus? I don't know.